An Illinois lawmaker has introduced state legislation to ban the use of double-decker trailers, and an equine biosecurity specialist has suggested steps to avoid a deadly pathogen. I'm Erin Ryder, news editor for The Horse, your guide to equine healthcare. Welcome to the Ryder Report for November 7th. In the wake of an accident involving a semi-trailer hauling 59 horses, legislation is now pending in the state of Illinois to ban the use of double-decker trailers to transport horses for any reason. State Representative Robert Malaro introduced HB 4166 on November 2nd. The measure would amend Section 5 of the Humane Care for Animals Act to ban the use of double-decker trailers for transporting equidae. Currently, Illinois does not prohibit transporting horses in such trailers, although federal regulations do forbid double-decker horse transport if the horses are en route directly to slaughter facilities. Of the horses involved in the October 27th accident, 17 died or were euthanized. A representative of the insurance company that took over custody of the surviving horses said they will be adopted out through the Hooved Animal Rescue and Protection Society of Barrington, Illinois. Society President Donna Ewing said volunteers who helped rescue the horses at the accident scene will get priority in the adoption process. There's still no official word on what charges the driver of the truck may face. See thehorse.com for much more on this story. Australia's Melbourne Cup went on Tuesday despite an outbreak of equine influenza that's brought the horse industries of New South Wales and Queensland to a standstill. Earlier this week, New South Wales Minister for Primary Industries Ian MacDonald announced that nearly half of the areas designated as restricted areas were reclassified from high risk to lower risk. MacDonald called the step the single largest advance made on beating this disease since vaccination began and the zone system was implemented. A spokesman for the Australian Bureau of Agricultural and Resource Economics estimated that the outbreak is costing about $3.94 million per day nationally. Equine influenza was first detected in Australia on August 17th. In Lexington, the American Horse Council held a day-long issues forum at Keeneland Racetrack on November 2nd. This is the second such forum held outside the council's base in Washington, D.C. Some of the topics discussed at the forum included land preservation, federal action impacting the industry, tax law for horse owners, pyroplasmosis, immigration issues, and an update on the work of the Unwanted Horse Coalition. Watch thehorse.com for more on the forum. Finally, equine health specialists are urging horse owners to wash their hands and clean grooming tools in order to reduce the risk of contracting an antibiotic-resistant strain of Staphylococcus aureus, known as MRSA. The pathogen, which has been blamed for the recent deaths of two boys, frequently resides in the nasal passages, skin, and intestines of horses. It can be transmitted via direct contact or contact with contaminated tools such as grooming equipment. Dr. Paul Morley, Director of Biosecurity at the Veterinary Teaching Hospital at Colorado State University, said washing your hands after handling horses is the most important method of preventing transmission. To increase awareness of the pathogen, the American Veterinary Medical Association is formulating a fact sheet to outline risk and prevention protocols. That's it for this week's Ryder Report. Watch thehorse.com for all the latest news on equine health, management, and welfare. This has been Erin Ryder for The Horse, your guide to equine healthcare. See you next week.